25 years ago, I looked around and didn't see what I wanted to see. And that was work that spoke to me about questions that I was asking. Questions that had been denied answers by my community, my family, and particularly the art world, the film and television industries. And so I set out to answer some of those questions and ended up producing a series of exhibitions that culminated in Yellow Peril Reconsidered that featured 25 Asian Canadian photo, film, and video artists. And that was not an easy task. It was produced against all odds from people who did not want me asking those questions and did not want me focusing on identity politics, racism, and Chinese or Asian Canadian sensibilities. I was told by many artists who I asked to be part of that exhibition that they didn't want to be ghettoized. I was told by the mainstream art world to stay away from that if I didn't want to ruin my career. We went about it and we produced an exhibition that I think helped galvanize not just with Asian Canadians but other communities to be allowed, given permission to ask questions about ourselves and the others that have not been part of our cultural landscape. So this was an opportunity to revisit some of those challenging and difficult, harsh questions that we were asking a quarter of a century ago, why we were marginalized and left out of the mainstream dialogue. To put together a program 25 years ago was very limited. There weren't many of us speaking out, making activist works, works that looked at ourselves, because we hadn't been allowed that. We'd been denied that as a community, certainly by our parents who were living in silence, living in shame, living illegally, living as oppressed migrants, coming from a past of violence and disruption, and being in a country and a place that was not very welcoming. They were coming from a place of severe racism, and in many cases, confusion, uneducated, and poor. I certainly grew up in a climate where things were just not spoken about for reasons of privacy, for reasons of safety, and reasons of denial, and also fear. So part of, I think, the process is to overcome that fear. The fear of being able to ask those questions and to look at what's possible. So for me as an artist, and certainly about this symposium, is creative freedom of expression. I mean, I think that's always been at the bottom, at the core of why I love art and artists. And for me, this opportunity to work with Kira and Jordan has been to be able to celebrate and to respect art, activism, and artists. And that's what the symposium's frame is around. There's a lot of academic, other kinds of conferences, symposiums, and exhibitions going around this issue this month. But in particular, we are here to look at what artists are taking risk and producing. So tonight's program is a selection of just a few of many, many, many works that have been produced over the last couple of decades that are asking some of those questions and going back in time, doing reenactments, or revisiting and rewriting and reclaiming our history. So please enjoy tonight's program, and we'll follow that up with a short panel discussion with some of the artists and curators that are present tonight. Thank you.